Hello everyone, welcome back to the part 4, that is chapter 4 of renal physiology. In this video, we will be learning about
juxtaglomerular apparatus.
Yes, without wasting much time, let's start.
The juxtaglomerular apparatus is a specialized organ situated near the glomerulus of each nephron. I hope you guys remember the structure of nephron, where you know that this is Bowman's capsule and efferent efferent arteriole, and this is the juxtaglomerular apparatus, where juxta means near, so hence it is called the near to glomerulus apparatus. Three parts are as named: macula densa, extraglomerular mesangial cells, juxtaglomerular cells. These are the three. Let's see in the structure, the three parts. First one, the macula densa, the round black part which is drawn. Second, extraglomerular mesangial cells, the dotted structures. And the juxtaglomerular cells, the blue one which is drawn. Now we will go into the depth of the three. So the three are macula densa, extraglomerular mesangial cells and the juxtaglomerular cells. First one, the macula densa. The end portion of thick ascending segment in each nephron runs in between efferent and efferent arteriole of the same nephron. So the efferent arteriole and the efferent arteriole and the same nephron's thick ascending segment, it runs between the through the black round portion, you can see. Now it is very close to the efferent arteriole. In this part, the cuboidal epithelial cells are tightly packed. As you can see, the efferent arteriole, it is slightly nearer to efferent arteriole and it has cuboidal epithelial cells which are tightly packed. This zone of thick ascending segment is called the macula densa. So basically, macula densa is a portion or a zone of the thick ascending segment.
Sorry to interrupt, but consider subscribing to my channel for more of medical lectures and health tips.
Second one, the extraglomerular mesangial cells. Now, extra means they are not inside the glomerulus, they are outside, hence the word extra are used. These cells are situated in the triangular region bounded by efferent arteriole, efferent arteriole and macula densa. As you can see, there is kind of a triangular portion. These cells are also called agranular cells, Lacey cells or Gore-McTi cells. Third one, the juxtaglomerular cells. Now, the wall of the efferent arteriole before entering the Bowman's capsule is thickened like a cuff. So this thickened portion is nothing but the juxtaglomerular cells, also called as polar cushion or polkissen. As you can see, the blue portion which I have marked, it is kind of cells which forms a cuff for the efferent arteriole before entering the Bowman's capsule. Let's take a quick look at the picture. This is the Bowman's capsule. And the round black portion drawn is the macula densa, which is nothing but the portion of the thick ascending segment. And as you can see, the extraglomerular mesangial cells are small dots in this triangular portion. And the third one is the juxtaglomerular cells, which is the cuff of efferent arteriole. So this is the briefing. Let's come to the functions of juxtaglomerular apparatus. The primary function of the juxtaglomerular apparatus is the secretion of hormonal substances. It also regulates the glomerular blood flow and the glomerular filtration rate, that is GFR. First function is secretion of renin. Now renin, it secretes. What causes the stimulation of renin? Let's understand that first. Whenever these things occur, such as fall in arterial blood pressure and reduction in the volumes of extracellular fluid, increased sympathetic activity, and decreased load of sodium and chloride in macula densa. These all cause stimulate the apparatus and causes release of a hormone called as renin. Now in blood plasma, what happens? There is presence of angiotensinogen, which is a alpha 2 globulin, and that in presence of renin, it stimulates and it forms the angiotensinogen 1. Angiotensinogen 1, it is physiologically inactive and serves as only as a precursor of angiotensinogen 2. Now in lungs, which secretes angiotensinogen converting enzyme, it causes formation of angiotensinogen 2. It is the most active and has many functions, such as it regulates the GFR. It increases blood pressure by vasoconstriction activity. Now let's take a look logically. Whenever there is fall in blood pressure, it causes renin formation, which forms later angiotensinogen 2, which increases the blood pressure. It kind of is of a feedback mechanism. It causes increase in water intake. It also causes increase in the ADH levels and secretion, and it increases CRH and ACTH. These all are kind of a feedback mechanism which causes the action of angiotensinogen 2, where you can see the renin functions, and it also causes increased aldosterone and vasoconstriction, which in turn are responsible. Angiotensinogen 2 is converted to 3 by angiotensinogenase, which has similar activity, both the 3 and 4, that is mainly increasing aldosterone and vasoconstriction activities. So this is the renin angiotensinogen mechanism, where renin secretion causes formation angiotensinogen 1, 2, 3, 4, which has respective functions. Now we go to the second function, which is secretion of other substances. The extragranular mesangial cells of juxtaglomerular apparatus secretes the prostaglandin, and its macular densis secretes thromboxin A2, which we see later. So basically, prostaglandins and thromboxin A2 are secreted. Regulation of glomerular blood flow and GFR, where it acts as a feedback mechanism called the tubuloglomerular feedback. Thromboxin A2 by macula densa causes contraction of the juxtaglomerular cells, which results in constriction, and it causes decreased blood flow to the efferent arteriole into glomerular capillaries. So basically it acts as a feedback mechanism. So these are the functions of the juxtaglomerular apparatus.
I will be uploading my notes on my Instagram as well as Facebook page. I'll link it in the description. If you find this video helpful, let me know in the comment section. You can watch my hematology series